Welcome back to Veda Day. I don't even know anymore, but today we have a very good video that I've actually been working on this entire month. As you guys know, I recently moved into my own apartment with my roommate Monique, and we have the goal to make our house just like really freaking adorable. So I've been recording every sort of little DIY thing that I've been doing for our house as I've lived here, and today I am here to share them with you. If you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen all of these because they're very Instagram worthy, they're very Tumblr worthy. So today I bring you three really easy room DIYs if you want to be like aesthetic and like really okay. Okay, let's jump right into it. The first thing we are making are these three very, very adorable things that are actually for your bathroom. So if you don't have your own bathroom, I'm sorry, but you can do this for other things. You can put like lotion in it. The things you will need are three bottles. I bought them in bulk on Amazon. I will link the exact ones that I bought in the description below if they are still available. The next thing you will need is a label maker. I bought the cheapest one on Amazon, but I made sure it was an embossing label maker. And then I bought the black with white lettering embossing label maker stuff. It came with it in a bundle. It was $14, I'll link it below. And then you'll need products to put inside of it, obviously. First, you have to plan out what you want to put in your bottles. I wanted shampoo and conditioner and then face wash. So I took the label maker and I very carefully made my labels. You gotta press hard on this, so if you don't have strength, ask someone to help you. And then I just cut them out and stuck them on the bottles and I repeated it for the other two bottles. I would also recommend you buy a funnel if you're gonna do this because I had a really hard time getting the liquid actually in the bottles, as you can see here. But once I did it, they looked like this, and they're super freaking cute. Here's an Instagram photo that I took of them. I know, it's so cute, I love them. Next, I'm going to be showing you how I made this cute little clipboard hand lettering thing to hang on your wall. I've seen this on Tumblr all over the place and I wanted to do it really cheap, so I bought this set of clipboards off Amazon. They were really cheap. They're really little though, but I kind of like that because I have a very small bedroom. The next thing you'll need is a computer. I'm using my iMac. You could use a laptop, it doesn't matter. And some really cheap printer paper. It actually needs to be cheap, but it doesn't need to be tracing paper because we're going to be tracing on it, but we want it to still be opaque enough so that you can like see through it. I'm talking really fast. I found a font that I liked online. I believe this one is called Moldy. I'm not sure, but I typed out what I wanted to, slowly traced over it with a pencil onto my paper. I then took a marker, but you can use watercolor or acrylic paint or anything that you have, and I went over the font that I traced out with the pencil, and voila, you now have it. I pinned it to the keyboard, and then I used a thumbtack to hang it on my wall. The last decor item is actually really freaking simple. All you will need is a Polaroid camera, a bunch of Polaroid film, some weird like burlap twine, and some thumbtacks. I had to use tape though because my wall is concrete and I can't put thumbtacks in it. But anyways, it'll look way better if you have thumbtacks. First, you are just gonna need to hang your strings on your wall like this. I already have them hung. Oh, you will also need a bunch of baby clothespins. They sell them at Walmart, but I bought mine on Amazon, so I will link them in the description. So you're gonna need to take a bunch of Polaroids. If you already have a bunch of Polaroids, that's great. If you don't, I recommend just going with a friend to like the city and taking a bunch of cute Polaroids in places. A cheaper alternative is you can actually Photoshop your photos into a Polaroid template and print it out. I will put it in the description if I can still find it on Google. I know I did that a couple years ago. It's definitely cheaper if you have a printer. I personally don't have a printer. So then you're just gonna need to pin the Polaroids onto it. You can do them any way you like, but I liked them very evenly. You can even do as many rows as you want. You could fill up your entire wall if you want. But yeah, I chose to do it like this and I really like it. And they fall on me every night while I'm sleeping because I can't use thumbtacks because my wall is concrete. But anyways, that is it for this video and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please remember to give this video a thumbs up and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!